That's why I can't sleep. Perfectly girlfriend-sized space next to me, but no girlfriend to be found, which is weird, because I distinctly recall having a perfectly fine, drop-dead gorgeous girlfriend in my apartment tonight. Just doesn't feel the same trying to sleep without her snuggled up against me. My big arms wrapped around her and her beautiful hair pressed against my face. I really hope she isn't sitting at some desk right now, burning the midnight oil, studying, instead of snoozing where she belongs.
Babe, that was your cue. Pull that cute little nose of yours out of that book and come to bed with me. It wasn't a request. You've already studied your ass off enough for this exam. You're going to do fine on it, babe. If you turn off the lamp and come to bed. Keep panicking and studying all night, you're going to ruin your sleep. And if you don't sleep, you're going to end up passing out during the exam. So, for your sake, it's time to go to bed, baby.
5 more minutes? Really?
No, you've done enough. Yourself out. Look at me. There you go. You've lost that cute little sparkle in your eyes because of that stupid book. How long do we have to have been together before you realize that I can tell when you need things like sleep? You can't hide those dark circles, babe. Don't get me wrong. You're still cute as ever, but it's enough. It's time for bed.
Nope, none of that. It's always just 5 more minutes. Now come on. You are coming to bed with me, and there's nothing to be done about it. No arguing. You know better than that. That's right, arms around the shoulders. Don't get too comfy resting your head on my shoulder, though, because I've still got to deposit you in your spot, where you're supposed to be. Where I can hold you all night. Let's get you all tucked in. And no escaping back to that desk tonight, babe. Good girl. Now come here. Scoot back and let me hold you. God, you're freezing. Good thing you have me here so I can warm you up in my arms. I'm serious, though. No more studying tonight. You're mine for the rest of the night. You know how much I love having my arms around you. I practically can't sleep without it, baby. I can hear your heart pounding. I know you're worried about your exam, but you've worked hard enough, babe. Don't ruin all the test prep you've done. Seen how much you've studied. You only think you need to study more because you're nervous. Once you sit down to take the test with a full night's rest,
The information is going to flow right out of you and right onto the paper. What if... Babe, what if I spontaneously combust right now? Or an asteroid hits our house? Or any of a million other things? You're not going to live your life worrying about what ifs, baby, and we both know that you're too smart to really think that. That's the only reason you're even in this course to begin with, remember? Because you're so incredibly smart. That's how you're going to breeze through that test tomorrow. No more worrying. Okay? It's time to sleep, babe. Still going, huh? Guess I have to resort to drastic measures. Never fails. You just melt every time I start to play with your hair like this. That's right, baby. Just curl up into a ball and let me hold you in my arms. That's right, that's it. That's my good girl. You've been such a good girl lately, haven't you? You've been working so hard, haven't you? You study so much. You're someone who seems to know everything I could ever want to know, and you still seem to have to know even more. You're just too good at what you do, aren't you? Yeah. Usually that's okay. Every night, what do? We get into bed at a reasonable time, and you curl up against me in my big old arms. You press your head against my chest. I play with your hair. Just extra cute when you...
See you soon.